morning. I'm not going to talk of the controversy that exists here with my particular family and their supposed non-rise to power in these past years, and the reason why. I believe particularly so, there have been, aside from attempts into the strange, with the helicopters that did go down in the southwest, hurtful events that have occurred specifically to hurt the women of the family. These events have occurred just as random, quite closely together, in sync at a very, very similar time frame. The Argentinian-Peruvian connection with the Perez name, I believe, is an association with possible retaliative persons in that warring zone of past years. Now, I want to say it's all over. And I'm not making a great vlog, and it's not a happy time. I'm not making fun. I did receive a present in the mail, and that's wonderful. But I do not want to really speak to the person. I don't want to call him. None of this is going on. I am in for sure knowing that the box is not filled with guns, and that would be extra funny under the circumstances of my name being a Guillaume. That, my gosh, just the guns, that's it, you know. Just call me the girly gunny Guillaume, you know. I could play tricks with them. I could make the tricks, you know. I could make them swirl and stuff, you know. You want the swirling Guillaumes here. Well, here I am. And so no, I did not get the guns. I believe it's clothes, like a packet of clothes, old clothes probably, or used clothes or something, or secondhand, or maybe if they're new, something from China that would not be suitable for my particular person. So thank you anyway. But no, it's not sending me the guns. I'd not get a packet of 8 Uzis, and that's what would be my preference, and I could just play with them. It's a trick. But nobody's fun. I can't play trick games with guns, you know. I can't be out here just tricking around with them and swirling them. And because it is absolutely a bad habit, but it would be a fun one to begin. But no, it's not a very fun family. They're not remembering our particular capacities of ease. And they're easy for us to handle and hold. And when they are easy for you to handle and hold, almost as if a comfort, but not a comfort to kill, just simply a comfort of a trick, a game with it. You know, that's who we are. We're not aggressors. We're not aggressors. We're not mafia, mob bosses, or anything really. That is all gone. That is all gone. Those days are gone. You know, we were ousted out. We were ousted out long time ago. Long time ago. They got, you know, that's it. This is all about lords now. We're all like, well, that is our water. That fountain there is our water. You understand? That is our water. And for some reason, it's been given to the papacy again and again and again. Gifts, gifts, gifts. And that is my money. That money that is coming out right there. Every day, a little drip drop on the little baby's head because he's blessed extra. Well, that's wonderful that he is giving the money, the parents are giving the money, that's a wonderful thing. However, that is my money first. It's my money first before any Christianity. I here became a human being in the bloodline. You understand, my blood existed before Christianity. Therefore, the business acumentation of the findage there in that fountain is mine. It belongs to my family, it belongs to my cousins, it belongs to my aunts and my uncles. The fountain of youth, lords. So in that take of it, much of its money is headed out, isn't it? It is headed out directly to pay for what? Pay for the parking lot? Well, for a moment it pays for the parking lot, yes. And then the next moment it pays for who? Sorry, I have to light the incense or something. I don't know, I can't find it, it's not here. I have to also I have to, moment, I'll get up and find it. Alright. So, because my family there has been in existence before the Christian Church, and that fountain is mine also, that means the proceeds of the event belong to me and them. So the contention also is a financial gain of this Catholic Church right now that is in power. They've overgained when we were driven out of France, specifically because of at that time, you know, we were the heavy Catholics that brought it in on everybody. At that time, there was that going on, and so they had a big serious, and I wanted to play fun with it. I wanted to play fun more. My gosh. You know, just dropped on me. You know, I have relatives here that are not doing anything. They're just sideline kicking around, playing desert world games with, hey, let's make another movie, Mad Max style. Let's not do Waterworld this time. We'll play Desert World in some stupid car. Well, go ahead, bring your Desert World car over there to Monaco and trip it around in its little wheelie gig. Maybe then you'll be accepted as some king of one of these ridiculous situations. Maybe then you'll be accepted. Go ahead and bring your fun and games over here. Meanwhile, I'm the only one who is even remembering it first. Because I'm the one who remembers it first, and I am the one, the first and foremost, that has to be the angry. Is this why I don't get the 8 Uzis in the box? What the hell is going on? Nobody's fun here. Come on. All kinds of fun games to play with the guns. You know, I have to trick them down the side of my leg and everything. You know, nothing is, gosh dang it. You know, this is like a muscle memory from before. What am I supposed to do? It's in my blood, it's in my muscles from before. It's like born into my body that I'm supposed to be playing tricks with guns. Oh, what am I supposed to do with this, you know? We're the funny ones. No, I don't think we really want to ever put the bullets for real, only the blanks. But then, you know, you go and you play with the gun with the blanks, and then people get like all upset. They're like, well, what the heck, you know, being shot at or something. It's like, gosh dang, I take it all serious, you know. And they take all the guns away. And then, oh my gosh, that would make for sure the worst day ever. I get all the tricks. I got the gun swirling down my leg really fast, and I have all this. I'm ready. Don't you understand? I'm there, and I am so ready and with it. And then they come and they take all the guns away because they have some rule. Well, forget it. I have to go higher than, I have to go back to it. I have to go back to, I'm the catapult. I'm the catapult creator also. I've created the catapults of Europe. The south of France, that particular monarchy I aspire from. My goodness. I don't even know the region really. It is down there above Marseille, but yet on the coast. Catapults. We are responsible for the catapults. They're all ours. And so, let me know all the others out there, kings and queens, they owe us for that particular invention. So, with the invention of the catapults, I don't know how we hold that to their head with our funny gun tricks, because we are capable of funny gun tricks. And you know it. You know we are just the Sorrelies. We are just into it. We are available to it. We handle weapons well. So we are weapons handlers. And no, that is not in the box. I did not get that in the gift box. probably just vitamins or something. Just vitamins and some, I don't know, some cheesy clothes from China. I don't know, not want to. I have too much of that other, let's see, the Black Prince. Have you seen him? The Black Prince, my little brother looks exactly like the Black Prince. The Black Prince was a dude who went over to the France during the Hundred Years' War in the midst of the bubonic plague and just lived there and pretty much set up shop and just enjoyed his life. But he's an exact replica. So what do I do when the exact replica is there in the painting and it is my brother? What do I do if he doesn't want to? If he doesn't want to claim himself as a Black Prince? It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. So yes, he carries quite a bunch of probably even body postures. I mean, even carry body postures as a direct like a copy. A copy person, you know, absolutely a photocopy of before, you know, when you think of the shape, the face, the mannerisms, everything, exactly. It's quite interesting, quite an interesting little philanthropy going through that time frame. And that is back a very long time. However, my gosh. The red-headed rulers of France. I did see this one king with a big nose, and I guess so. He does look like my older brother. He does have the same hair, and he put the rose oil there on his wavy hair when my brother was young. Is the exact same look as an Egyptian with the rose oil on. So he's looking exactly like that particular. And so that is a wonderful, but I'm not really sure the history of it. I'm not really sure that particular history. That would be a good one to find out. Absolutely, because what happened? And I'm more interested in the father of that particular reign. Was that father an aggressor? Was he the aggressive to the son? Did he actually have demonstrative leanings over, you know, in a controlled fashion over their lives? Because that also would be an interesting, does it happen again? Does history repeat itself again? You know, even in a familial, in a family time, you know, the father being the exact same repetition of pattern. This has already happened. So that would be an interesting history to look into. I'm not sure the king exactly, but he's the red-headed one in profile with the little wavy, soft. Looks soft. Yeah, the rose oil is soft. So where am I next? I don't know. I was going to talk about the fishing, stopping the fishing, and by you saying, yay, I am the king of France, by one of my brothers declaring themselves king of France. There is the absolute tremendous, hey, those are your fish, you know, those are the king's fish, and all of that occurs, and because those are the king's fish, that means they're not the British fish, they're not the Irish fish, they don't belong to Denmark, they don't belong to anyone aside from France, and so those remain non-allowed to eat by the others. And so it does end the EU, little everybody can have, because I believe it has been quite an overcapacitator for certain countries specifically. But they have used the EU as their eating mechanism, their big buffet. Like, hey, well, I will go buffet there specifically because they have octopus special. Let's get Greece. I want the octopus. I want to eat the little teensy squids every day. We will get Greece because they have a little teensy squid. We want them for no other reason but their fish. You know, this has been going on and on. Add another one in. What is with the turkey? The turkey only has apricots. We can grow the apricots elsewhere. You know, it's the claim of what for food? What food does each country bring to another? And right now I'm seeing the big food hungry holler piggles, and the big piggle itself is Britain. Great Britain is the big one. The Hungary also, I'm not understanding why they have a large, overfattened populace, but they have gained weight quite dramatically over this particular time frame. Extra, so it is an odd thing to see the Hungarians get extra fat. So that is unusual. It's like the EU has made them extra fat. You know, we're in the EU now, so we can just relax and let our stomachs out. I'm like, what is going on? What's not going on here? You know, they're just feeling so cozy in the EU, they can just eat an extra munchy crunchy. You know, this is terrible. So yeah, there's a little bit of, hey, we're relaxed here, everyone. Aren't we relaxed? We're all so relaxed, we're pretty much stoned out of our gourds. Well, we have to remember there is the old way of being stoned out of our gourds, and that is war. And we don't ever want that to be occurring here on any of these soils of the European Union. We have the maintenance of the people, and we have to make sure that we do stop certain things, such as discriminations. Now, me already being forceful and saying, no, British are going to be, you know, British name, surname owned, surnamed persons specifically are to be owning the French soil. That is already setting up, you know, already setting up the slander of discrimination, attempts and attacks again and again, and somebody will be, well, this is some kind of a nationalistic tantrum that will occur, and they will start throwing stones back and forth at each other, and that escalation will rise. But that is going to have to happen. We will prefer this rather than have big business continue to destroy what is currently here, because it is too hard to return to. The people we have to change on another level. But big business is a big pocket, isn't it? It's a big pocket, they're making money, and that is its only reason, its only rhyme. So we have to control the big business. Now the people on the other, with their nasty habits and attitudes that, oh my gosh, then I'll exasperate wars between Britain and France. Well, that, I guess, is the diplomacy factor that is available through my brothers, and in their invitation into the monarchy, their diplomacy, because they are of both relations. They have had and held the monarch lines of Great Britain and Spain, and also here in the France. And remember, we are the catapult creators. So with all of this catapult creation, my goodness, there is a grudge held, isn't there? There could be grudges held back on us from a long time. You know, that was a heavy stone. That was a heavy stone in my direction. Way too heavy. Perhaps that castle really needed to be sieged, and it didn't. You know, so there could be grudges going back that far. However, there is still this odd, strange lurk. There is the odd, strange lurk with my family that there is some kind of strange assassination or try of that it does hurt. That does go to an odd why? Why did that happen? Why did those helicopters go down? Why do things oddly happen? Like my cousin and the flip out of her vehicle in the desert. Why did that happen to her? These types of things. So we are thinking already because of the I will say it is a South American connection. The South American connection specifically, that would be the reason. So yeah, when we're getting into global politics, I don't know. What was I speaking? Catholic Church family. And then we're here, you know, we're dragging the Catholic Church back in, you know, our monarchy drags the Catholic Church back in because we're sequestered with it. It just swirls around us. We cannot stop at the Catholic Church. It is an existent that we have to deal with, and it is very much a part of us. Even though I may not be the Catholic and preaching it, it is still something I definitely am, have an acumen of knowledge with. So, yeah, that fountain is ours, everyone. That fountain of youth is ours, you know, those proceeds also. And I believe I said this already. Is this a repeat? I don't know. I was trying to claim the fountain as ours, because we were here before, before Catholicism. But yeah, back to Egypt also. Back to Egypt, leaders of Egypt. So, because of family, it also goes back to be the leaders of Egypt. This is an exciting moment. However, it's not exciting to be in the public eye at all. It's a very dangerous place. And so, there is a restative that definitely we wonder. You know, is it worth it to even come out and start talking about the fish? Is it even worth it? You know, is this only about the overfishing of? You know, certainly there are other politics, but right now that is one of the major ones. That is one of the major ones. You just you know, those are yours as the king. Those are the king's fish. Just like the queen over there in England has many times expressed, those are her swans. Even though they are here landing in France, they're her swans. So there you go. She's overstepped already her bounds with the swans. Yeah. Try to keep your swans and your fish, you know, closer to your shores. And claim them only there. And try to keep your buffet wants a little closer to home. Stop trying to eat fish from Greenland. It's not really a fair practice, is it, to keep placating and keep demanding, really, more and more children being born again and again from illiterate persons. It is not a very good practice of the British monarchy currently that they have been condoning, that they have been letting happen. Perhaps they have really lost true power. Perhaps they have really lost true power. And that was originally King Edward's fight. One of his major fights that got him into all of his troubles was he did not want ever this Parliament action. The Parliament action was the danger. Because you do lose quite a bit of control over the leadership of what is going on. And you have what? Are they there watching television? Where? They're not watching the Queen again and again any longer. You know, it's out of fashion. There is a moment you bring it into fashion, you have the young there out there, and there's the young princess wife, and that's beautiful and everything. But that is not going to keep the population contented. It's not going to keep them contented. They're still going to be demanding their fish from Greenland. That's really all they were looking for. That's all we've created. A bunch of persons that just want to keep fattening on these fish from Greenland. From Iceland. From tremendously far distances. You know, squids. Squids all the way down to the Greece. Way too much. Given to persons that are uneducated, that are ill-equipped, that do not deserve, that are absolute lowlifes, along with many other names. Why are they getting the buffet? Why are they eating such a rich plethora of feast? How come they have been allowed to eat such a great gift? A great gift of the world. When they do not deserve it. We have to stop this. We have to stop giving them so much. Too many choices. They've had way too many choices. This is a choice pullback, everyone. Their only choice right now is contraceptive. Do they want to take the condom or the pill? Those are their choices. And right now, I don't believe they are putting on the condom. So then the choices become, well, you have no choice, they all have to take the pill. And stop trying to create the population war. Stop creating a population war with expanding nasty people. Nasty persons that are spreading out all over the EU, that are buying properties, that are shoving their dissertations around of property owning because they have the money. Because they have a deed, a paperwork. Because English was spoken here. Bringing in their translators, bringing in their, oh, well, I learned a few French words, I can buy a French place. Way too easy. They have dropped in, they put their finger in every pie here. You understand? Every pie, every puddle, every lake has now had a British foot in it, saying they want to play. They want to play in the swimming pools. It's summertime. These are not persons that deserve to be playing in summertime pools. At the luxury and whim as if they are kings and rars. This is not their luxury. They are not deserving of. Enterprise has given this deservance to them. Merely enterprise. Businesses. Businesses have been their leaders. Businesses are not a leader. Businesses are merely a commercialization product that is trying to sell, is trying to make at the bottom goal. At the very bottom. What is their money? What is their bringing? What is their profit? How many planes can they fly into France this summertime? Right now, that is their goal. That is their profits. That is all they're querying and that's all their question is. They want the answers, and they want more. That is business. That is who your leaders have been. They do not care the persons that are carried on those planes. They do not care the persons that are traveling here in cars. They do not care. Only if there is the wealth factor associated. The wealth factor of discredient human beings spreading out all over Europe. All for money. So, yeah, we want them out. They're not welcome. Certain property owners are welcome, but certain ones are not. It's just a sticky mess, just goo, it's just a terrible, terrible mess. Taking trailerfuls of old refrigerators all the way to Spain. Putting them in houses. Television shows on the British airwaves, selling it again and again. The property, the property. So we can blame the BBC, we can blame the BBC for the push. We can blame all of these TV shows for the push. The expansionism of property, property population, rule. That's right now the new world that they're in. It is a property population rule. So, Britain has become an over-hungry beast. And we have to quiet its stomach. We have to stop these shows also. They keep pushing. They keep pushing them all over the place. I've seen them being pushed down to Morocco, into Egypt. I've seen them being pushed into Tunisia, going by, you know, going by another place, going by another place, you know. What is the reason? What is the reason for these shows? Well, they need something to entertain that many persons, first of all. They're enjoying. They're enjoying it. Outright enjoying. But yet, the places they land are not an outright enjoy. They have become, they've become upsets, financial upsets to the persons. The visitations are difficult. The distances are difficult. They've pushed it. It's way too easy to go, blah, 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 here and there. It is not that easy. It is not that simple. It's big travel. I'm here, I'm there, I'm gone, I'm everywhere, you know. It's not that easy. We don't want their old elderly arriving here and with us having to deal with corpses all of a sudden. Strange corpses and houses of persons that are not even from anything to do with the region. What is going on? This does not make any sense. We're dealing with the plague. At this point, it's become a plague. I do not ever want to say the British persons are a plague, but they have become so. So they have to tone down this population, and they have to start selling these contraceptives immediately to the British public. When you have the one child, it is a gift. When you have the two child, perhaps it is another gift, maybe too many. However, you start having the three, the four, the five. In this day and age, on that island, it is no longer a gift. It's no longer a gift. So, I guess that's all I'm gonna say today. I don't know. I just wanted to play fun with the trick guns, you know. Just invest in my guion for a while. But then there's the Perez, De La Perez is out there, you know, and I'm like, oh my gosh, well, yeah. I don't know, I wanted to play fun at the Stockers, with the De La Fontaine, very fun one also. It's just been a bummer. It's been a bummer of a life so far, hasn't it? It's not great. It's just not great. All this ecology, I have to keep saying it 100 times over, and it's like it's never ever gonna stop. It's never gonna stop. You people just keep going on with it and on with it. It's just like, what a tiring situation. What a tiring EU this has been. You know, they don't change their habits, they're still not going vegetarian style, they're not changing their habits with population control. You know, this is just like, we're on this big, we have to beat China, you know, we'll be the billion over China. I mean, get over it. You're never going to be the billion over China. That is the wrong reason to up your population. It's just a disease at this moment in time that has been. This leader, there has not been no leader to make the choices for the persons. There has been no leader up to this time, in many, many years. It's just been a bunch of little tea dumping sconetas. They've not said enough, demonstratively. It's only been about war, elsewhere. Meanwhile, allowing their own persistences of ugly, uneducated, illiterate persons to keep remaking more of them. Warfaring persons that demand nationalistic specific, that demand discriminations, don't even want to know the persons that live north of their own countryside. Don't even want to speak to the persons who live south of their own countryside. It's an absolute cesspool of uneducated illiterates all the way up to the hoity snoities spouting it out, which are from the north. Speak to the north. So that's pretty much it. I'm getting tired of looking at my face today. Yeah, anyway, I don't know, agreement there, patrol agreement, put a few boats out there to make sure the enterprise of business does not continue overfishing. The British do not continue having their British businesses overfishing on the French waters, and they are territorial waters. So, yeah. And don't start any war over it, but yeah, it's an agreement and it has to happen. And that also means the French don't go on their side. Just polite. Be polite about it. And eat the food only from your water areas, and the food only from your lands. And then you'll understand right away that you need contraceptives.